Now, let us talk about the meaning of wavelength on the basis of wave motion. Consider the vibration of red particles and black particles. We do notice the vibration of red particle is same alike, and vibration of both the black particle is same. But the vibration of red particles and black particles not same. The phase of vibration of black particle and red particles are different. Red particles are in same state of vibration. Also, both black particles are in same state of vibration. But red and black particles are not in same state of vibration. Now you guess which of the following particles are vibrating with same state of vibration. The answer is none of them, because all are vibrating with different timings and different heights and different length. Therefore, none of the particles are in the same state of vibration. In this vibration, we observe all particles vibrating with same length and same amplitude at the same time. We see all the particles are vibrating in same state of vibration. In this wave motion, we got yellow colored and red color particles are vibrating. And there are the two specific particles with the black color. We observe both the black colors particles vibrating with the same state of vibration. That is, they are going maximum and going minimum at the same time. We see both the black colored particles vibrating in the same state of vibration. So, the distance between both the black particles is nothing but called wavelength. Even the violet colored particles also in the same state of vibration. Therefore, physical distance between two violet color particle also gives wavelength. We notice that in this vibration, even the white color particles are vibrating with same state of vibration. That is, they become maximum and minimum at the same time. So physical distance between these two white color particles gives the wavelength of wave vibration. We also notice that no other particles are vibrating as the white color particles are vibrating. So these two white color particles are in the same state of vibration. From this discussion, it is clear that in a wave motion, there are the only some particles in same state of vibration. All particles are not in same state of vibration. In this vibration, particles A and B are consecutive particles and they are having same state of vibration. Particles B and C also in same state of vibration. Particle B and C are consecutive particles, but particles A and C are not consecutive particles. So distance between AB is wavelength of the wave. Distance between BC also wavelength, but distance between A and C is not equal to wavelength. Even though A and C are in same state of vibration, but they are not in consecutive particles. Therefore, distance AC not equal to wavelength. Now, I am going to explain you the meaning of period. For that, I got some 9 coins and I got the first coin flipping. I got second coin not flipping, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 7th, 8th not flipping, but the 9th coin again flipping. So same kind of motion is repeated after some particular time. Let us say 8 seconds. That means after 8 seconds, same kind of vibration is repeated. Same kind of motion is repeated. Time required to repeat the same type of vibration in case of wave motion is nothing but called period of vibration, period of motion, or period of the system, whatever it may be. In this animation, we got large number of particles vibrating up and down, and these particles are shown by red color. First case, particle is starting from point A and traveling up to the A dash and coming back to the point A. So it is completing its cycle A, O, A dash again to the A. One cycle is completed. Time taken to complete one cycle of vibration is called time period. We observe the second particle. Even the second particle starting its vibration from point F through O, traveling up to the F dash, again coming back to F. Thus, it is also completing its one cycle of vibration. And it is also taking the same time as the point A is taking. So, time taken by the particle to start from point F, again come back to the point F, that time is nothing but called time period of vibration. Similarly, in case of longitudinal waves, time span between two compressions or time span between two rarefactions is equal to its time period. Similarly, the distance between two rarefactions or two compression is equal to its wavelength. In case of transverse waves, the distance between two successive crests or troughs is called as wavelength. And in case of longitudinal waves, distance between two successive compressions or rarefactions is called as wavelength. Wavelength is denoted by letter lambda. From above discussion, we can define wavelength as the distance between two successive particles which are in same state of vibration is called wavelength. Wavelength can also be defined as the distance traveled by a wave in one time period is called as wavelength. Wavelength is given by wavelength equals to velocity of the wave upon frequency of wave.